Besides, I hear you've been busy making yourself the Empire's most wanted.
I wanted to prove to the galaxy that the Empire isn't invulnerable. That you can resist. That you have to fight if things are gonna get better. But then they just listen to the propaganda and they pretend they're free anyways.
You chose a hard path.
And it hasn't made a difference.
Well, while the Empire's trained its eyes on you, we've been able to build the network. Find allies. And save lives.
When you left, you'd just given up. I was wrong.
Cal, you were just a child when they sent you off to war. You know, there was a time when I remember that the Jedi were more than just weapons. But we both have our roles to play in this struggle.
But that's why I'm here. Seer.
Will you get a load of this? Hey, Seer, you can't say it ain't short of personality, but kind of creepy, though.
Well, it's good to see you two, Grease. Well, hello, BD.
Okay.
So, how was your time in the desert?
The storm covered our tracks, but the Empire destroyed one of your speeders.
It's a small price to pay for everybody's safe arrival. And who's this?
This is Bodo Kuna. He's a friend.
It's so nice to finally meet you.
This hunk of trouble! Hey, we're all together!
Yes. Now, what brings you all to Jeddah?
We're searching for a lost planet. Tantalor, you ever heard of it?
It's on the other side of a deadly nebula called the Kobo Abyss.
Well, our archives are far from complete, but I'm sure Master Cordova is up to the task.
With pleasure. The trouble is, we're not the only ones looking for this place.
I knew this was sounding too easy.
The guy's name is Dagon Gera. He was a Jedi. Now he leads a band of raiders on the Outer Rim. There's an old temple there. Dagon intends to reclaim it.
A Jedi temple out of the reach of the Empire could mean that there's information there that we don't have in the archive.
I believe I have something. Oh, you're too kind, BD. I'll start with the bad news.
Oh, boy. This guy knows his audience.
I found no information related to crossing the Kobo Abyss. However, I found two mentions of this Dagon Gera. He had a retreat on Kobo, and records show him frequently visiting a laboratory on its moon.
Okay, we'll check him out.
If you find anything, bring it to me. I am happy to assist further.
Thank you. Both of you.
You're welcome, Cal. I hope you find what you're searching for.
May the Force be with you.
And with you.
I will escort you back to the Mantis.
So you're not joining us?
I cannot.
I've had this since I started freelancing. It's gotten me out of some bad situations, and I figured it might do the same for you. It's Marin, right? Well, I could get another one if you think you might want it.
No need. Phone.
Yeah, you're good. Okay.
My master always frowned upon using blasters.
You once said it wasn't the weapon that makes you a Jedi.
It's us against the galaxy, Cal. We've got to use every advantage we can find against the Empire.
Thanks, Bode.
Show you how to use it.
A real stormtrooper won't stay still.
Gotta start somewhere. There you go.
Not bad, right?
So, how long have you been working for Seer?
I do not work for Seer.
Right. My mistake. Relax, Cal. Just concentrate and pull the trigger. Got it, Cal. So where are we headed first? Back to Kobo, or its moon?
I think we should check out the High Republic settlement first.
Yeah, let's scope it out. Dagengar was bound to leave something behind. This is a smart operation Seer's put together.
Why do you say that?
All this rock? Natural shielding against sensors.
Yeah, and if anyone makes it past all that, the Anchorites have plenty of holobooks to throw at them.
Yeah, you can see how Seer's managed to evade the Empire for so long. She makes her own luck. Keeping so much of her power held back to achieve a larger goal.
Yeah. There's definitely more to her than meets the eye.
You two have that in common. Ready to roll out when you are.
It's nice seeing you again, Marin.
You too, Cal. Good luck. Perhaps I will still be here when you return.
Hope so. I can't believe Master Cordova is really here. That time following in his footsteps.
I have enjoyed getting to know him. I've never met a Jedi with a better sense of humor.
You've only met me and Seer.
That's right. Cal?
Now, where should we go next?
Maybe those Anchorites aren't so bad after all.
Didn't you call them weirdos?
That was before Seer told me they're helping those poor refugees hide from the Empire.
That right?
Yeah, working with the group called the Hidden Path. Real hush-hush stuff, so keep it in the family.
Understood.
It was nice to see everyone again.
Yeah, it really was. So, Cordova thinks we'll find out how to cross the Abyss by tracking down Dagon's old haunts?
That's right. You ever been there?
Once. Used to be a settlement. Now it's just a bunch of crumbling stone spires and creepy ruins. You ready, Cal? We're almost there.
Thank you.
Next, let's go to... Master Cordova's research shows an abandoned settlement past the east side of the valley. Let's go check it out. Know anything about the High Republic residences on Kobo?
Oh, when I first got here, I did a little exploring of my own. I went into a place, and then I heard creepy voices, and I got out of there in a hurry.
I'll let you know if I hear any voices, Grease.
Wise guys. Not now, Cal. I'm pretty sure Monk reorganized my entire spice rack. But I don't know exactly what he changed. But I don't hate it. Huh. Could he actually know what he's doing? After being back on the Manus, this saloon is looking filthy by comparison. Maybe some cleaning will help.
How did Boglings end up on Kobo?
You can thank Grease for that. He brought him here on accident, is what I heard at least. Raiders kill him in droves. I've seen him.
How would anyone kill a Bogling?
Exactly. You can't eat him. Can't skin him. Can't even trade with him. One of the Bedlam Raider chiefs used to shoot him for fun.
Just point me in his direction.
Don't bother. I handled it already.
All right.
Watch yourself out there.
You do the same, Mosey.
Hey. Got a sec? Watch yourself around the stone spires, Cal.
What'd you hear?
Apparently the Raider base isn't too far from there.
Thanks for the warning.
When Kobo's moon was shattered, the Republic settlement collapsed, leaving those spires. That place isn't just an old ruin. It's a tomb. Don't forget about that shattered moon. Cordova seems to think it was important.
Good call.
It might just be Grease's stew talking, but this place is beginning to grow on me.
Private table.
All right, then.
Whoa, easy, Grock. Sorry about my friend here. He's just a little guarded.
Yeah, I get it.
Name's Dana. You might say my partner and I have a talent for turning opportunity into profit.
I'm Cal. This is BD.
Noisy little thing.
We're thinking of heading to Dredger Gorge. Ever been?
Once or twice. I'd be careful out there. That's gang turf.
Gang turf?
Grock, I'm sure it ain't that bad.
The hell I'm risking my neck on gang turf.
Hey, it was great meeting you, Cal. Got some business to discuss with my old pal here.
Come on, BD. So how'd you two meet anyway?
All started with this merc crew I joined. Grock had been recruited a few months earlier.
On account of my good looks.
That's right. And me on account of being the smoothest thing since Hutt Blubber. Anyways, things were good until our outfit tried to pull one over on the Empire. So we
took off and started our own thing. The rest of the outfit ended up dead or in prison.
With the car, Grock. I was telling it.
Kid doesn't need our whole life story.
Point is, Grock and I realize that we're better off just the two of us.
We know the feeling.
How you doing?
Barkeep.
Good to see you, Cal.
So you and Grease have any big dreams for this cantina? Please excuse me. Hey, Monk.
You look tired. Take a load off.
So you and Grease have any big dreams for this cantina?
Well, there's a stage collecting dust. Perhaps one day we'll hire some off-world bands. That'd sure help us stand out.
I'd say standing out isn't your problem.
Fair point. But just so you know, the band at my previous gig packed more heat than a hot solder guard.
And until this raider situation is under control, let the music play on. Ever pick up any good tips from bartending?
For starters, every client has a tell.
What's my tell?
Well, if I told you, it wouldn't be a tell.
Fine. So what's your tell?
My incurable honesty. Hey, sport, can't chat now. Keeping an eye on those two treasure hunters who just showed up. Remember to relax every now and then, will you? Too much tension in the coils is bad for the joints, if you catch my drift.
Cal, I heard about a meditation chamber.
You gonna check it out?
Oh, I wish. It takes some serious acrobatics to access it, and...
I could give it a shot, Toa.
A shot? This coming from the guy who scales basalt pillars in the time it takes me to date my field journal. Happy hunting, you two.
You know anything about the High Republic settlement off towards the swamps?
Well, of course. The whole area was devastated when the moon fell on it. You're heading there, aren't you?
Yeah. Need some information from the ruins.
Watch your step. Rockfall is a big problem. Unless increasing your friction coefficient is another one of your talents. That was a physics joke.
Okay. Thanks for the warning.
You know, you've got a core world air about you. It's becoming.
You from the core?
Guilty as charged. I studied the galactic economy with some of the greatest minds of Coruscant. Then watch those same minds ooze into obscurity while real opportunity whistled by.
Real opportunity?
Oh, you know, tax-free trade, extrajudicial imports, what have you.
Oh, you mean smuggling?
What I mean is that the galaxy is begging to fill your pockets if only you play its game.
Oh, local legend holds that those ruins are chock-full of ghosts. Of course, I would not believe in that kind of thing. But you tell me if you saw one, yeah?
You bet.
Another time.
So what'd you do before you came here?
I used to perform in a medicine show. I was required to dress in garish outfits and read fortunes, while others would scam the audience.
That sounds a little demeaning.
Yes, but the experiences we carry always have a use, Sojourner. When I arrived on Kobo, I noticed a charlatan trying to swindle someone with fool's priorite.
How'd you know?
He wore long sleeves in the heat.
Sleight of hand, huh? I saw a merchant on Corellia do that.
An old trick. Well, I stopped the sale, and Doma has been grateful ever since.
And the swindler?
Tried the trick on the raiders, so I hear, and sealed his fate.
So, your trip to the forest worth the risk? Nice to see you.
Tempting.
It's delightful to see you fully intact.
Holding up okay?
Fine. fine, thanks. It's not the first time this frontier has been terrorized by marauders, you know. But once more, the noble Jedi Knights rise to the occasion.
I appreciate the thought, Z, but we should watch the whole noble knight stuff.
Yes, of course.
Not a bad selection.
A strong choice, certainly. Farewell, my friend.
This is encouraging. I bet we can plan even more.